Dear students, in this video we are going to discuss about the sterilization by filtration technique. This particular technology is used for the sterilization of liquids and gases mostly, and the gases sterilization is done by using the membrane. This can be observed when we are having the hospitals or we are in the industries. The complete area is maintained aseptic with the help of membrane filtration technique. That is, sterilization of the air is carried out by using the filtration technique. Hence it is having equal importance like the other sterilization techniques. The filtration sterilization technique is able to remove the microorganism. It will not kill the microorganisms. This process is capable of preventing the passage of both viable as well as non-viable particles. Thus, it can be used for both clarification and sterilization purpose. This process of sterilization is used for the sterilization of heat sensitive injections, ophthalmic solutions, biological products, and for the sterilization of the air or other gases which are supplied in the aseptic area. The main mechanism will be sieving, adsorption and trapping. By these mechanisms, these filtration technique is occurring, or it is following the principle of sieving, adsorption and trapping. Then these at industrial levels, the membrane filtration becomes a part of venting system on fermenter, centrifuges, autoclaves and freeze dryers. Certain types of filters like membrane filter have important role in sterility testing. It is employed to trap contaminating organisms from solution under test. These filters are then placed on the surface of a solid nutrient medium and incubated to encourage colony development. The major mechanism, as I have told you, is sieving, adsorption and trapping within the matrix of the filter material. There are two types of filters. One is membrane filters and second is the depth filter. Membrane filters are maintained or obtained from a cellulose esters or other polymer material, while the top depth filters are fibrous pads, sintered glass and sintered ceramic products. So now in the next slide we are going to check the different characteristics of membrane and depth filter. Here we can see that there are different characteristics like absolute retention of microorganisms, rapid rate of filtration, then dirt handling capacity, then shedding of filter components, fluid retention, like that. So here we can see that plus sign indicates that these things are applicable to these filters. Here the rapid rate of filtration is applicable in the membrane filter. By mistake it is negative, so consider this as a positive. While that of the other components, from these 9 characteristics, almost 7 characters are applicable in the depth filter. So by this we can know that the depth filters are capable more than the membrane filters. Membrane filters can have the absolute retention of microorganism inside them or in the upper layers of the membrane. While that of depth filters will not have the retention, but it will be slightly till the end, it will be having the retention, not only in the earlier stage only. Then here there will be shedding of the filter component. Then fluid retention will be there. Then solute gets adsorbed in the filters. There is good chemical stability and Good sterilization characteristics can be seen in both the filters, membrane filter and depth filter. Well, that of mostly when there is a requirement of the sterile air, then instead of membrane filter, depth filters will be preferred over membrane filters. Now we will see the filtration sterilization of the liquids. In filtration sterilization, microbial removal efficiency of filters is very high. For liquid sterilization, membrane filters of 0.2 to 0.22 micrometer pore diameter is used. The efficiency of filtration mainly depends upon the pore size of the filter. Here we can see that this is a particular pore size of the filter, and it will be able to trap the molecules of this particular size, and it will be allowing the other particles of the liquid through the filtrate. So pure liquid is passing through the filters so that the sterilization of this particular liquid can be done by using the membrane filtration, and the efficiency basically will be depending upon the pore size of the material. For superior filtration, sieving effect, trapping of organisms within the filter matrix, then the adsorption and the depth of the membrane, then its charge, then tortuosity of the channels, these all factors are equally important. Filtration sterilization is an aseptic process, and careful monitoring of the filter integrity is necessary, as well as we have to go for the sterility testing of the product which is sterilized by using the filtration technique. If it is only membrane filters are used, then it might happen that it may not give the sterility testing completely positive, that is the sterility will be assured, it will not happen. So for that purpose, sometimes sintered filters can be used for the re-sterilization. Re-sterilization is not possible by single membrane filter. Hence the sintered filters will be used for the re-sterilization purpose. The membrane filters are often used in combination with the coarse grade fiberglass depth pre-filter. That means the combination of a glass depth pre-filter and membrane filter will be having the improvement due to their dirt handling capacity. So in combination with the glass depth pre-filter, the membrane filtration efficiency can be enhanced. So this combination can be used when we are having the sterilization of the liquid by using the membrane filter. Here we can observe that this particular membrane filter is allowing the sterilization technique by trapping, first is sieving, then trapping of the contaminants or the microorganism inside this filter only, that is, this is a filter matrix. So in this filter matrix only, it is getting adhered and trapped. So this molecule is not able to pass the membrane, and we can have the liquid getting sterilized. Next technique is filtration sterilization of the gases. This is a typical example of the filter which is made up of pleated sheets of glass, and these pleated sheets of glass are supported with the aluminium sheets of the craft paper. That is, this will be in the aluminium sheets. So it will be having the application. Such type of filtration sterilization of the gases is important where we are having the provision of sterile air. So this sterile air into the aseptic manufacturing area or in the hospitals, that is in the hospital, in the ICUs or in the operation theaters, the aseptic condition will be required. So this aseptic condition in that particular room can be achieved by having the air gets sterilized. So for the air sterilization, we need the filters. So these filters can be employed in the ducts, in the walls, or in the ceiling panels or overhead canopies or in the laminar airflow cabinet, so that whatever air is passing into that room, it will be passed or it will be forced through that filter only. And when the air is passing through this filtrate, then the air gets purified and gets sterilized as well, so that we can have the sterility in that particular cabinet or in that room where we are supposed to have the aseptic condition. These high efficiency particulate air filters, that is HEPA filters we call, so these HEPA filters can remove up to 99.997% of the particles greater than 0.3 micrometer in diameter, and thus they will be acting as the depth filters. So for removal of the microorganism, this efficiency of these particular filters is very high, as major microorganisms are associated with the dust particles. So it is going to have the trapping of the dust particles, right, as well as the fungal spores also. So air will be forced through the HEPA filters by blower fans, and then pre-filters before these HEPA filters. Again, pre-filters are used so that these pre-filters can remove the larger particles of the dust, and these can extend the life of HEPA filters. Suppose the air is directly passing through HEPA filters, so whatever lifespan of HEPA filter is there, that will be minimized, so as to increase the life of the HEPA filters, because we have to concern the life of the HEPA filters as well, because it will be a costlier affair. So it will not possible to change the filters within 6 months. So sometimes the membrane filters or depth filters, whatever are used, these will be replaced with the material, or sometimes complete replacement, depending upon the situation, depending upon the assurance, it will be changed. Certain other applications are also there of the filtration sterilization of the gases. There is, first is sterilization of the venting air in the tissue and microbial cultures, then decontamination of the air in mechanical ventilators. Third is the treatment of the exhausted air from the microbiological safety cabinets. And fourth is the clarification and sterilization of the medical gases. So by different applications or by using different membrane and depth filters, we are able to have the filtration sterilization. That is, sterilization will be done using the filters. So these filters will be either membrane filter or depth filter. We can have the sterilization, which will be useful where air cannot be sterilized by heat or other techniques. So here we have to go for the membrane filtration. And different membrane filters, depending upon the pore size, these are available in the market. So depending upon the requirement, the industries or hospitals are going to cover up their area with the help of different filter papers. So here we are finished with the filtration sterilization part. Thank you.